So today is pitcher rail day. I've got about 9, 10 metres of pitcher rail to get up in the dining room before we can finish off the painting and lay the floor. So it should be a fairly straightforward job. We've done the other two rooms on the other side of the house and we've got a couple of hours now to get this done. So I'm going to show you how we're doing it and show you a few of the bits and bobs that you need to do it yourself. So obviously you need the pitcher rail itself. This is the standard MDF moulded pitcher rail. Comes in 2.4 metre lengths and that's what we'll be using. So as you can see, these have been primed and painted. Did about 30 lengths when we did the other side of the house, so these are ready to go up on the wall now. And as with all trim, it's much easier to paint this stuff when it's off the wall, and then you can stick it up and just touch up the holes afterwards. So next you need a mitre saw, whether that's an electric mitre saw like this or just a little mitre box, either or is fine. Obviously when you come to do any angles which are not 45s or right angles, you're going to struggle. If you're using a box, you'll have to make up something. However, on a fully adjustable sliding mitre saw, you can just find out what angle you need and then we can cut it on here. Okay, other things you'll need. So tape measure, obviously just to measure out the lengths. You can do a lot of this by eye, just by holding up and marking, and it's just as accurate, but good to have a measure anyway. Pen or a pencil to mark that. And then a drill bit big enough to act as a countersink really. I drill halfway through with this and that way I can bang in a masonry nail and I've still got plenty of space to fill and paint over the top. You can use countersink bit if you want to, but the nails tend to go through the moulding absolutely fine. So I drill half the way through with this and then we'll bang the nails in. Once the nails are in, a little nail punch just to sink them well into the moulding itself, into the pitcher rail, and make sure we've got enough space to fill over the top. Next you want to make sure you've got a good coping saw, and this will be really important when we come to do the joins on the corners, so we can scribe over the moulding itself, and we'll cover that in a minute. Filler of some sort, just to fill those holes so you can dry and paint over afterwards. Again, we'll show you that in a minute, and just a way of smoothing over the filler as well. And then obviously a drill to drill those holes, and lastly just some construction adhesive, just so you can put a few dabs along the length for when you put it up on the wall. And that's just an extra way of making sure it's nice and fixed to the wall, and should you want to hang anything from it, you know it's going to be strong enough. Okay, I've made a start already. All these walls are 100-year-old masonry walls and the plaster is pretty uneven, but as you can see, these have gone on nice and tight. So what I've done is put adhesive on the back of here, and then where we've tapped in the masonry nails, that's pulled it tight against the surface. And then what we can do is just run a bead of cork under there where needed to get everything flush. And here's a little close-up. You can see where I've drilled the hole and punch the nail through and well under the surface, and we'll go along and fill that now so we can paint at the end. Now it's always best to start in the corner of the room, kind of furthest from the door. That way when you do your scribing in the corners, you're looking onto the join itself rather than kind of back at the scribed end. Either way, we're going to get a nice tight fit, and by the time it's fixed to the wall and painted, it should be nice and flush. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut a compound angle, just take 45 degrees off the end. And you can make sure you've got 45 degrees just by putting the piece, flip it over, just holding it up and just making sure that that is a right angle. All good. So what you then create, if you can see that, so what you then create is when you look at it square on, you've got the side profile. So what you see here is the core of the MDF is the exact same as
an end profile. And basically that what that does is that gives us that line that we can use our saw and we can come along on that. So we'll do that now. We'll just clamp this down to the workbench. So here's the cut end where we've cut that 45 degree angle cross section through the moulding. And what we want to do is just keep our blade vertical and we'll cut away that pattern. Okay, so now we've got our profile there. So here's our moulding all cut and that profile cut out at the end. And a good way to check is just to get a little piece of scrap wood of the same moulding and push that into it. And just check you haven't got any huge gaps. You can then use a file to go around just to perfect the scribe there. So we can then offer that up to the corner. Get it nice and snug across to there. And we'll mark our next corner, which is this external corner. And I normally just put a little dash just to make sure I don't make a mistake on which angle I'm going back. And we'll cut that. Okay, so we've cut our external corner now. We'll go up and have a look. Just double check it for size. So again, make sure you butt that mitre right into the corner. I've got an additional mitre where it hits the where it meets that window frame. So good, we'll get a level on that when we come to attach it. Okay, so we can put those bits aside. Okay, so we've got our two pieces cut for this side of the window. We've got our double angled piece which will go into the window frame. Then we've got the external corner here. And I've cut that to fit. And remember, you can always cut long and just take a few slithers off when you come to a corner, just to make sure you get a nice fit and you haven't cut it too short. So now we know those are okay, we'll put those to one side. The next piece is going to be a full length coming down this wall, and we'll be scribing the end to sit over this one. And that's what I said about the entrance door being the furthest away. So the entrance is over there, and we'll be looking down the scribed end, so that way you get a nice finish, and when you're looking at it, the joint will look at its best. And because this wall is longer than a single length of the moulding, we're going to need to do a joint halfway along the wall. And rather than just butt jointing them together, which quite often you will end up splitting and you'll see a line through the paint, what we'll do is just mitre both ends, like a scarf joint, and that will just give us a nice flush join, and also a little bit of more surface area to put a bit of adhesive on. So it can be either direction, but we'll cut a 45 degree mitre on that now. Okay, so we'll make a start drilling and getting ready to fix these pieces up on the wall. So as I said at the beginning, I tend to use an oversized drill bit for the nail, and I just go about half the way through the moulding. And what that does is just gives a little hole to start the nail off, and also a big enough hole for the head to be in and punched down, ready for filling. And every moulding's different. This is a fairly standard moulding, and I tend to put the nail hole in here, in this sort of flat section. So I would normally drill about halfway through this, which will give us probably a 5mm deep hole to sink the nail into. I just tend to find, although it's probably a better fixing point to go through here, it's much harder to fill afterwards and be able to follow that curve. Whereas this flat edge, you can get a nice scraper on there, palette knife, and get a good finish.
So there we go. That hole goes about half the way through the moulding. We'll tap our nail in there and then punch it through, and that'll give us a nice hole to fill afterwards.
Now the more uneven the wall, the more fixings you're going to want to put in. Just so you can follow the contour of the plaster, really.
Especially anywhere near the joints, where you've got a mitre joint or a scarf joint, you want to make sure that your fixing is just like an inch or two from that corner, so you can control the tightness of the joint. So our first joint is that one up on the first corner with the scribed end. We'll put three fixing holes along there, and then we've got another mitre piece to go around the reveal of the window. So I'm going to put a bit of adhesive on here now and make a start. So there's our first piece ready to go in. Got some steel masonry nails that are held in enough just to hold there whilst we hold it up. And a bit of adhesive on the back. So you want to make sure you've got everything to hand, especially if you're working on your own. Tool belt's really handy in this situation. So what I tend to do first is to put the scribed one into the corner, because we're going to be levelling off this one. Push it in nice and tight, just eyeball it to start with to get it level. And then we'll tap in our first nail. What we'll do is take the spirit level, sit it on top. Bring it down level and give it a little bit of a push as you nail it in. And what we'll do is, when we come to this external corner here, we're putting this piece up straight away, so I'll leave that last nail so we've got a bit of movement and we can just make sure it's perfect before we secure it to the wall. Now we've got to put this long piece up here, and this is where the preparation of getting all those fixings in the moulding ready comes into hand, because if you haven't got someone to give you a hand holding it up, you can end up in some sort of yoga position holding everything up. So we'll get everything ready as much as we can. Okay, so once again, we want to make sure we've got everything ready. Spirit level hammer. It's a little bit easier once you've got something to sit the new scribe onto, but it's still not going to be that easy. Okay, so we want to level off that corner so we can pop it on there. And I don't want to get any adhesive on the wall until I know we're about level. So holding it off the wall slightly. That looks right to me. So the first thing I want to do is tap in the middle nail. And I'm pushing against the scribe all along. We can see the bottoms are lining up the other end, so that's good. And then it's just a case of going along methodically and checking the level and hammering in all the way along. So next job is just to punch in these nails.
So here's that mitre joint where we need to join the two lengths along one wall. So that's a 45. Our final piece goes in there, and the corresponding 45 sits on there, giving a nice flush finish. And then once we've fixed this to it and painted over, you won't see that at all. Okay, we've now done all three walls of the dining room. I've got the final piece of the jigsaw, which is just a little mitre which goes into the chimney breast at the end of the kitchen. So we'll just take a little slither off to get that to fit, and then we'll look at filling the hole. So that's the picture rail up, and as you can see, it's looking great. A few little bits of tidying up to do still, but that's how we approached it with our DIY method. So I hope that helps. There's lots of ways of doing things like this, so if you've got any other suggestions, please put them below. Also, if you've got stud wall, obviously things are going to be a lot more simple, and you want to pre-mark those fixings so you know exactly where your verticals are, and you could use screws or nails in that situation. If you were going to be hanging very heavy mirrors or paintings, then I'd suggest probably using some screws instead of the nails, just so you've got a bit more strength there and you can get some plugs in the wall for that. And if you've got any tips or suggestions for other people, please leave them in the comments below. We'd love to hear your thoughts, and if you've got any questions, we'll try and answer them too. So thanks for watching, and please remember to subscribe to keep up to date with the restoration and further DIY projects. And also give us a thumbs up, because it really helps the channel. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.